Hello students, today we will learn the next illustration, illustration number 6 relating to the computation of taxable pension. I'll read out the question. See the question. Mr. C retires from ABC company on 30th June 2019. He gets rupees 2000 per month as pension up to 31st Jan 2020 with effect from 1st February 2020, he gets 60% pension commuted for rupees 40,800. Compute the taxable pension for assessment year 2020-21. Does it make any difference if Mr. C gets gratuity of rupees 40,000 at the time of retirement? Second question, Mr. C is a government employee. If Mr. C is a government employee, so we have to compute here the taxable pension. We have to compute taxable pension for assessment year 2020-21. So we have to compute in two cases, that is in three cases. That is, first one is assuming he is not received gratuity. And second case is if he gets a gratuity, what is the treatment? And third one is if he is a government employee. So three solution we have to do. So we'll see the question. Mr. C, he retires from ABC company. It is a non-government company. Private company. Mr. C retires from ABC company. It's a private company, means non-government company, on 30th 6 2019. So he retires on 30th 6 2019. Then after retirement he gets rupees 2000 per month as pension. So after retirement he will be receiving a pension. He will receive a pension, that is 2000 per month he will be receiving a pension after retirement. Up to 31st Jan 2020, he will be receiving a 2000 per month as a pension. That is, from retirement till 31st Jan 2020, he was receiving 2000 per month. Next, with effect from 1st February 2020, means the next day, with effect from the 1st February 2020, he gets 60% pension commuted. So he will opt his pension commuted, that is 60%, that comes to rupees 40,800. So from 1st February he planned to commute 60% pensions and he received rupees 40,800 as a commuted pension. So here we have to compute the taxable pension for the assessment year 2020-21. We have to compute the taxable pension. Means we have to compute both commuted as well as uncommuted pension here. Commuted as well as uncommuted pension. So here we have to compute taxable pension, means commuted pension as well as uncommuted pension. So we know how to calculate the commuted pension. What is the exemption? If he receives a gratuity, then it is 1/3 of full commuted value of pension. If he does not receive a gratuity, then half of full commuted value of pension. That we know how to compute the commuted pension. Now we see how to compute this uncommuted pension. So after retirement, see here, after retirement, when he retired, he retires on 30th 6 2019. He retired on 30th 6 2019, means after that he will be receiving 2000 per month pension. After that he will be receiving pension, how much? 2000 per month. He will be receiving pension 2000 per month up to 31st Jan 2020. So from 30th 6 2019 till 31st Jan 2020, he was receiving pension 2000 per month. Okay, he was receiving pension 2000 per month. So from 1st February 2020, he planned to receive 60% pension. 60% is nothing but commuted pension. So before he used to receive uncommuted pension. This is a 2000 per month is nothing but periodical pension. 2000 per month is nothing but uncommuted pension, isn't it? This is a pension what he received from June to 31st Jan 2000 per month is a uncommuted pension. After February he received a commuted pension. So after February he received 60% commuted pension, means in the 100% pension, in the 100% pension from February, in the 100% pension he received 60% commuted. He will be receiving 60% commuted pension. He planned to commute 60% out of 100% total pension. What is the total pension? His total pension is 2000 per month. So in the 2000 per month pension, 100% means 2000 per month. In the 100% pension, 60% he planned to commute. Means balance how much? 40% is uncommuted. Uncommuted. So here we have to compute the uncommuted pension. So which all uncommuted pension here? One is from 30th 6 2019 till 31st Jan, he received pension 2000 per month. That is uncommuted pension. And one more is in the 100%, 60% he commuted, means balance 40% he will receiving periodically per month pension. So periodical pension he will be receiving 40%. So now we have to compute total uncommuted pension. Now see the solution. So firstly we have to compute calculation of write the heading calculation of uncommuted pension. So here when he retired on 30th 6 2019. So after retirement means this is a June end 30th. So next month onwards, from July month onwards, he will be receiving 2000 per month. So that is from July to till 31st Jan, till 31st Jan he was receiving 2000 per month pension. So that is from 30th 6 means we can't include the 6th month June, because it the last month, last day he retired. From the next month onwards he will be receiving pension, means July, August, September, October, November, December and January month also. January month also we have to include, means it is the end of the January. So totally 7 months, July to Jan, totally 7 months. So that is from the next day of his retirement, next month of his retirement, that is July to 31st Jan 2020. So he received 2000 per month, means 2000 into 7, 14000 is a uncommuted pension. 14000 is a uncommuted pension. Next one more uncommuted pension is in the from 1st February 2020 till the year end, till the previous year end, 1st February 2022 till the previous year end, he received 40% of pension uncommuted, means 60% he commuted. Here they have given 60% pension commuted, means balance he will be receiving periodically. So 2000 into 40%, how much? 800 is he is receiving periodically. Means what is the remaining month here? Till January he received 2000. Next from February month he received 60% commuted and 40% uncommuted. So now we are calculating uncommuted. So take only the part of uncommuted. So 40% is uncommuted. So it comes to 800. So how many month he received 800? 40% means 2 month. February and March month he received 800. So total uncommuted pension comes to 15,600. So this is a total uncommuted pension which is taxable for the assessment year 2020-21. Okay, so total taxable pension it is, which is this pension is earned in the previous year. So it is from 1st July 2019 to 31st March 2020 what pension he received is taxable in the assessment year 2020-21. Understood, right? So this is about the calculation of uncommuted pension. Now one see the format of pension. So uncommuted pension, the periodical payment of pension is fully taxable. If it is a government employee, if it is or non-government employee, for all the employee it is fully taxable. We should not see check whether he is received a gratuity or not. There is no such a condition. Whatever the uncommuted pension he receives is fully taxable. So here in this question total uncommuted pension how much? 15,600. So this pension amount is fully taxable in all the cases. So in all the cases we have to add uncommuted pension 15,600. So we'll see in the solution. Now we'll prepare the solution one by one. First we have to solve the solution for the this particulars, assuming he does not receive a gratuity. So first case is here they have not given the information of gratuity. So first case is he is not received a gratuity. Second case, does it make any difference if he receives a gratuity of 40,000? Okay, that is, this is the second case. And the third case, if he is a government employee. First two cases he is of a non-government employee. He is retired from a ABC company, means he is a non-government employee. And third case we have to assume it as a government employee. Now we'll see the solution. First one. So if Mr. C is a non-government employee, first they asked to compute if he is a non-government employee and does not receive a gratuity. In the first paragraph they have not given any gratuity info, so we have to take as a he does not receive a gratuity. So this is the solution. Don't write A. Solution for A means the next question, if he receives a gratuity. So under that write heading computation of taxable pension for the assessment year 2020-21. Write heading taxable pension, not a taxable commuted pension. It is, we are computing total pension. So under that, as usual, how we calculated earlier the commuted pension, similarly you have to compute. So write commuted pension. The difference is only write commuted pension. This one I given heading, that is for your identification purpose. So first, what is the formula? Actual commuted pension received. So what is the commuted pension he received amount? How much commuted pension he received? How much? That is, he gets 60% pension commuted for rupees 40,800. So the commuted pension is nothing but 40,800. So actual commuted pension received is 40,800. Next, exemption under section 10 subsection 10a. So he does not receive a gratuity here. So what is the formula? Half of full value of commuted pension. So 1 by 2 into 40,800 is a commuted pension. In that full value we have to take. So how much percentage he commuted? He commuted 60%, means 60 by 100 it is. So we have to write 100 by 60. So here we have to write 100 by 60. So it comes to 34,000. So 34,000 amount of commuted pension is exempt. So balance is taxable commuted pension. So 6,800 is a taxable commuted pension. Next we have to add. So in case of Mr. C, if he is a non-government employee, he has to pay tax on commuted pension as well as non-uncommuted pension. So uncommuted pension what he received is fully taxable. That is 15,600 is fully taxable. So that we have to add. So commuted pension 6,800, uncommuted pension 15,800. This amount we have I took from this calculation, 15,600. So the total taxable pension how much? 22,400. This one we have to add. Understood, right? So if he is a non-government employee, if you want, is just see the formula once. Yeah, in case of we are calculating non-government employee, right? In case of non-government employee, if he receive a periodical pension, uncommuted pension, it is fully taxable. If he commute pension, in case of non-government employee, conditions apply. That is a gratuity received or that condition. So based on that, if he does not receive a gratuity, means half of commuted pension is exempt. So balance is taxable. So total taxable value is 22,400. So the next we'll see. Yeah, we have done the solution for the non-government employee if he does not receive a gratuity. Next, we'll see, does it make any difference if he receives, Mr. C gets gratuity of 40,000 at the time of retirement, whether it make any difference if he receives a gratuity. Yes, it makes a difference because the exemption amount is how much? It is 1/3. If he receives a gratuity, the exemption will be 1/3. So it makes a difference here. So write the heading, Mr. C is a non-government employee and receives a gratuity. Computation of taxable pension for the assessment year 2020-21. So firstly, we have to compute the commuted pension. In that, actual commuted pension received same 40,800. Difference is we have to take 1/3 because he receives a gratuity. So write exempt under section 10 subsection 10A, 1/3 of full value of commuted pension. So 1/3 into 40,800 into 100 by 60. So 22,667. So if you deduct, we'll get the value 18,133. So that is nothing but his taxable commuted pension. Next, we have to add uncommuted pension. So the uncommuted pension is fully taxable in the all the employees. Okay, so 15,600 he has to add uncommuted pension. So the total taxable pension comes to 33,733. Yes, here it makes the difference. So if he does not receive the gratuity, taxable pension is 22,400. If he receives a gratuity, then the taxable pension will be 33,733. Next, we will see the third case. What is the third case? B. Second question. If Mr. C is a government employee, what is the solution? So, when Mr. C is a government employee, so see the format again. In case of a government employee, what is the treatment? So, commuted pension, uncommuted pension, or a periodical pension is fully taxable in both the employees, non-government as employee as well as government employee. It is fully taxable. The one who receives a periodical pension has to pay tax on that pension. Means it is fully taxable. In case of commuted pension, if commuted pension is received by government employee, then it is fully exempt. Okay, it is fully exempt. So here we have to write, Mr. C is a government employee. So commuted pension of ₹40,800 is fully exempt in case of government employee. But in case of non-government employee, it is a 1/3 of a full value of commuted pension if he receive gratuity. Only to this extent it is exempt. But in case of government employee, it is fully exempt. Whatever the amount he receives as a commuted pension, fully exempt it is. Next, in coming to uncommuted pension. So uncommuted pension will be fully taxable in the hands of all the employees. Means 15,600 uncommuted pension what he received, that should be taxed. So the total taxable pension in case of a government employee is 15,600. Understood, right? Now this illustration is for homework for you. The similar question it is. Similar question. I'll read out the question. See the question. Homework. Illustration number 7. Mr. S retires from private company, means non-government employee, on June 30th, 2019. He is paid a pension of 7,000 per month. So after retirement, he will be receiving a 7,500 per month as a pension. Okay. He commutes 75% of pension on December 1, 2019. From December 1, 2019, he will be planned to commute. Means from June 30th, 2019 till December 1, he received a 7,500 per month uncommuted pension. Next, after that, he decide to commute 75% of pension and receives 4,50,000 as a commuted pension. Compute the taxable amount of commuted and uncommuted pension for the assessment year 2020-21. So it means here in the 100%, total 100%, 75% of pension is commuted, means 25% of pension is uncommuted. While computing the uncommuted pension along with the pension 7,500 per month, we have to add 25% of pension, that is from December to that year end, means previous year end. We have to take from the year, from the date of his retirement, means from the date of his retirement he will be receiving a pension, till the year end we have to compute that pension, and from that pension we have to tax in the next assessment year. Okay, that. So next is compute the taxable pension of commuted and uncommuted, taxable amount of commuted and uncommuted pension for the assessment year 2020-21. Assuming if he has received a gratuity of rupees 5,40,000 at the time of retirement. So we have to assume he received the gratuity of 5,40,000, means what is the treatment here. Second one is if he has not received a gratuity of at the time of retirement. So at the time of retirement he received only, assuming in the first case we have to assume he received after retirement pension as well as gratuity. Second is he received only the pension, not a gratuity. What is the treatment? Third case also state the tax benefit of Mr. S would have enjoyed in respect of commuted pension if he were to be an employee of a government of West Bengal. It is nothing but if he is a government employee, what is the treatment? So first two cases is in case of a non-government employee. Third case is if he is a government employee. So in case of a government employee, there is a tax benefit, right? Tax benefit means in case of a commuted pension, it will be fully exempt. It will be fully exempt in case of a commuted pension. He has to pay tax only for the uncommuted pension. So here it is exempt. Answer is, they asked only in respect of commuted pension. No need to add uncommuted pension. Only we have to write in case of a government employee, if he receives a commuted pension, the tax benefit is exempt. Or commuted pension what he received, that is 4,50,000, is exempt to him. That is nothing but his tax benefit. Understood, right? So this is a homework for you.